Hello everyone, my name is Ashish Dubey, working as an assistant professor in the Department of Civil Engineering in Maharaja Institute of Technology, Mysore. In today's session, I am going to discuss about module number 2 of basic surveying with subject code 18CV35. Module number 2 is measurement of directions and angles, which is unit number 1, and unit number 2 is traversing. Okay, so what have you studied in the last module? The last module you have studied introduction of surveying and measurement of horizontal distances using various instruments such as chains, tapes, right? In this module, along with measurement of the horizontal distances, we also need to measure the directions and angles. For that purpose, what should be done? What is the instrument used to measure the direction? So that we'll come to know in this particular module. Okay, so what are the topics that I'm going to cover in this session? That is compass surveying, traversing, meridian, bearing, true meridian, true bearing, magnetic meridian, magnetic bearing, and the designation of bearing. Okay, well, first let me tell you, last module you had dealt with the measurement of horizontal distances using chains, right? So chain surveying is convenient only when the surveying is done in a smaller area. Chain surveying is sufficient, but when we come to a larger area, this chain surveying alone is not sufficient and it is not efficient as well. What happens? You need to change the directions as well along the surveying. So at that time, what you need to do is you should also measure in which direction to move and what is the angle between the two survey lines. The angle between the lines can be measured. So for that purpose, we need some angle measuring instruments or directions measuring instruments. So directions can be measured using an instrument called compass. So you know what is compass? A compass is nothing but which is used to indicate the north and south direction. You people have seen a compass, right? In compass, there are two types of compass which we are going to deal with in detail. That is, first one is prismatic compass and the second one is surveys compass. So that I will be dealing in the later sessions. Now we know what is compass surveying. That is, when the surveying is done in a smaller area, chain surveying is sufficient. But when the surveying is to be done in a larger area, chain surveying alone is not sufficient. We need to measure the directions of the survey line as well as the angles in between them. So chain surveying is not efficient. That's why we have to use a instrument called compass. Okay, and that two types of compass are surveys compass and prismatic compass, as I have told earlier. Next, what do you mean by traversing? See, before going to the compass surveying and in detail about it, we should also know what is traversing. Let us consider a number of survey lines that form a framework, and if you start your survey from a starting point A and it forms a closed circuit, that is, you start from A, go to B, C, D, E, and again come back to A. This forms a circuit, closed circuit. This is called as closed traverse. See, what is traversing actually? See, along with the measurement of length, we also need to measure the directions. So for that purpose, we should have some directions measuring instruments along with the measurement of the length. That is, chain can be used to measure the length, but also we need this compass to measure the directions of the survey lines. Okay, so if the survey lines form a closed circuit, that is, when you start the surveying from A to B, C, D, E and come back to A, this is called as a closed traverse. So this can be done when you are traversing around a compound. Okay, so let me give an example for open traverse. What do you mean by open traverse? So let us assume you are starting your surveying or traversing from A. See, from A to B you can measure the distance, and what about the direction that is being measured from a compass? So okay, so you will traverse from A, B, C, D, E, F, G. What happens? You are not coming back to A. So when you traverse across a river, this case arises, open traverse. So that can be taken as a best example. Okay, so this comes under open traverse. See, closed traverse, open traverse, again we'll be dealing in detail about it in the second unit of same module. Okay, next, how many instruments are there? What are the different types of instruments which is used to measure the direction? To measure the direction, the instrument used is compass, and to measure the angles we have instrument called theodolite. Okay, so I'll be dealing about the compass in this particular unit. Fine. So okay, so these are some basic concepts required for your compass surveying and traversing. Now let us move on to the next topic, that is meridian. What do you mean by meridian? In the last module itself, you people have dealt with meridian and the basic terms related to it. See, meridian is that reference line or geographic north and south pole of the earth. Okay, meridian is nothing but geographic north and geographic south of the earth. Okay, and the bearing, what do you mean by bearing? Bearing is nothing but it is that line whose direction is measured by taking this meridian as a reference line. So if this meridian is taken as a reference line and this line is your survey line, whatever the angle between this reference line to the survey line is there, that is called as a bearing. Understood? So bearing is nothing but it is a horizontal angle made with respect to the reference meridian. So these are your basic concepts. What is meridian and what is bearing? Now let us understand what is true meridian and true bearing with an example. If you observe this figure, so this is your geographical north and this is your geographical south. So this will not vary, it remains constant, right? So this line is nothing but it is can be called as a true meridian. So what is true meridian? True meridian is a line that intersects with the surface of the earth, that is, let us take this point as A, that intersects with the surface of the earth and geographical north and geographical south. So this remains constant. This is nothing but the true meridian. Now what about the true bearing? So what I have done, I have considered a line here, that is a survey line. So the horizontal angle which it makes with the true meridian is called as true bearing. I repeat, the horizontal angle with which the survey line makes with the true meridian is called as true bearing. It remains constant. Now coming to what is a magnetic meridian. Magnetic meridian is nothing but people have seen a compass wherein it shows north and south pole with a needle attached to it, right? So this meridian is nothing but it is a needle, that is freely floating needle and well balanced and free from all other attractive forces, so this is magnetic north and magnetic south. Okay, so this is called as your magnetic meridian. Similarly, what about the magnetic bearing? Again, it is nothing but the horizontal angle made with respect to its magnetic meridian. It is the horizontal angle, horizontal angle which it makes with the magnetic meridian is called as magnetic bearing. Understood? So I'll tell you one more time, what is true meridian? This is the geographical north, geographical south, and a point on the surface of the earth intersects and it is constant. And what about the true bearing? True bearing is nothing but the horizontal angle which is it makes with the reference meridian, which is here in this case is true meridian. Similarly, this is magnetic meridian and magnetic bearing. I hope this is clear. And next we shall go to designation of bearing. Designation of bearing is nothing but how do you express the bearings, in what terms you express the bearing, or how many systems are there. Okay, so let me erase this. Designation of bearings. There are two systems in which we can designate the bearing. That is, first one is the whole circle bearing system. What is done in this case is, in whole circle bearing, the bearings are measured in clockwise direction. Please keep that in mind. Clockwise direction. As the name suggests, it is a whole circle. The angle varies between 0 degrees to 360 degrees. 0 degrees to 360 degrees. Okay. The first one is, it should be measured in a clockwise direction. Second is, the angle varies between 0 to 360 degrees. And what about the reference meridian? Reference can be taken as north or south. If you take north as a reference, measure all your bearings with respect to north. If you take south as a reference, measure all the bearings with respect to south in a clockwise direction. Okay. And at last, the whole circle bearing system adopted in prismatic compass. In prismatic compass, the readings are graduated in the whole circle bearing system. I'll show you in later sessions. Okay. So this is with respect to whole circle bearing system. And now let us understand how many quadrants, what are the readings, how do you express whole circle bearings. Okay. The first one is whole circle bearing . This is your north, south, east and west. And what about the readings, angles? I told you that it starts from 0 degrees, clockwise 90 degrees, again it will be 180 degrees, here it will be 270 degrees, again when you can come back to here, it will be 360 degrees. It completes a circle, whole circle, right? And let me name the quadrants in a respective manner. So this will be my first quadrant, second quadrant, similarly it will be third quadrant, it will be the fourth quadrant, right? So same quadrant should be mentioned here. So this is first, second, third and fourth. Okay. So let me consider a point here as A. Let this point be A. Okay. So we know the readings, all the graduation 0, 3, 0 to 90, 180, 270, 360, whole circle. Now, what I told you should measure your bearing in a clockwise direction only. What I will do, I will consider a survey line AB in the first quadrant, and I will consider a survey line in the second quadrant as AC. I will consider one more line in the third quadrant as AD, and let me consider one more survey line in the fourth quadrant as, not AE because E is already used as east, so let me take it as F. Okay. So according to this system, how do I measure the bearing? As explained earlier, it should be measured in a clockwise direction, either by taking north as a reference or south as a reference. I am going to take this north as reference meridian. Therefore, I am trying to measure the bearing with respect to this reference meridian. This gives me the bearing of the line AB. And let me treat it as theta 1. Got it? So I am measuring this bearing in a clockwise direction. Similarly, I should take this north as reference for all the bearings irrespective of the quadrant. So let me start measuring from this reference meridian to the second quadrant line AC and let me name it as theta 2. Let me name it as theta 2. Okay. Similarly, when you are trying to measure the bearing of line AD, you have to start measuring it from the north direction or the reference meridian with respect to north. Let this be angle theta 3. Similarly, you cannot write in an anti-clockwise direction. No, it is wrong. Okay. You should travel in a clockwise direction only. So, take this clockwise till here, theta 4. See, if you observe this pattern, it looks like it is a whole circle. Am I right? So, the bearing of the line AB is theta 1, bearing of the line AC is theta 2, bearing of the line AD is theta 3, bearing of the line AF is theta 4. That you have to write here. That is WCB of the line AB is theta 1, WCB of the line AC is theta 2. Similarly, WCB of the line AD, A to D is theta 3. Similarly, the whole circle bearing, that is WCB of the line AF is theta 4. So, this is how you express the bearings in WCB system, all the whole circle bearing system. Got it? Okay. So, now let me move on to the next system, that is quadrantal bearing. It is also called as reduced bearing. Or also known as RB. So, let me erase this. Okay. In this system, the angle can be measured in clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction. Clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction. Okay. I'll tell you how. Second is, the readings are here graduated from 0 to 90 degrees only. The angle varies in between 0 to 90 degrees only. This system is graduated in the surveyor's compass. In surveyor's compass, the readings are graduated with the minimum reading being 0 degree and the maximum reading being 90 degrees. Okay. So, this is with related to quadrantal bearing. Now, let me show you with diagram. Again, I will write the same quadrants. This is north, south, east and west. And one more important point which I deliberately left out there is, here the readings are measured, or the bearings are measured eastward or westward only. Eastward or westward only. Okay. So, let me take this as 0 degrees. This is 90 degrees. Sorry, I will write the degrees here, because there will be no confusion. See, this is first quadrant. Quadrant bearing, what do you mean? The name itself suggests that it is related to a quadrant. This is first quadrant, 0 to 90. Next, coming to second quadrant, again the reading will be 0 here. it will be 90 here. Third quadrant, 0 here, 90 here, and so on. So the main thing here is maximum angle which we can measure here is 90 degrees, the minimum is 0 degree. Okay, so coming to this figure, here the bearings can be measured in a clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction, first point. Second point is it should be measured eastward or westward, okay, whichever is nearer. Well, let me take an example. I'll consider a point A here. So this is my first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant and fourth quadrant, okay. So let me consider a survey line AB. In the first quadrant, let me consider a survey line AC. In the second quadrant, let me consider a line, survey line in the third quadrant as ED. And let me consider a survey line in the fourth quadrant with the name AF, not AE, because E is already used as east. Okay. So the important thing here is you can measure the bearing in a clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction, and it should be measured eastward or westward depending on whichever is nearer to the reference meridian. Okay, so for this survey line, reference line with respect to north is very nearer to line AB, survey line AB. So this can be measured in a clockwise direction and let the angle be alpha. Okay, now coming to the second quadrant, line AC, this line AC is nearer to south or nearer to north? Can easily make out that it is nearer to south. So you should measure your bearing with respect to south. In which direction I am measuring? It is anti-clockwise. So let me write the angle as beta. Similarly, when I come to survey line AD, south is very nearer to this survey line. So I can measure the bearing in clockwise direction. See, clockwise direction. Let this angle be theta. Okay. Now coming to this fourth quadrant line, survey line AF. Now this survey line is very nearer to south or north. You can easily make out that this north is very nearer to this line. So we should measure the bearing in anti-clockwise direction with the angle being phi. Okay, got it? So let me repeat one more time. Taking the north or south as a reference meridian, you should measure your bearing towards eastward or westward. Either it may be clockwise or anti-clockwise. It should be measured eastward or westward depending on whether that line is nearer to this north or this south. Clear? So if you take this survey line AB in the first quadrant, and if you measure the bearing, it should be in a clockwise direction with the angle being alpha. When you come back to survey line AC, it is nearer to south and the angle is being measured in the anti-clockwise direction with the angle being beta. Similarly, when you come to the line AD, it is near south and it is measured in clockwise direction with the theta. Similarly, this line is very nearer to this north, so it is measured in anti-clockwise direction with an angle of phi. So now let us express this. How do we express? So quadrantal bearing or reduced bearing, usually we use RB in this particular system, reduced bearing of line AB is, let me make some space, reduced line of AB is north, what is the angle? Alpha east. So north is the reference meridian and it is measured towards east. Similarly, reduced bearing of line AC is south beta east. South beta east. South as the reference meridian, this is the angle measured in anti-clockwise direction and this is measured eastward. Got it? Similarly, the reduced bearing of the line AD is, again taking this S as reference, south clockwise theta, south theta measured westward. South theta westward. South theta westward. Similarly, coming to the last line, reduced bearing of line AF is, yes, A to F is measured with respect to north, 5 towards westward, anti-clockwise direction. North, 5, west. So this is related to your reduced bearing, or how do you express the bearings in quadrantal bearing system. In the coming sessions, I will explain you how to convert the one system of bearing into the other, that is WCB to RB and RB to WCB. If you have any doubts, you can leave it on the comment section. Thank you.